Australia's leading sports organisations have made a pledge to tackle youth binge drinking.
Now when you watch your favourite sports like football,
basketball,
swimming,
netball,
an Australian uni sport,
you won't see alcohol sponsorship.
You'll see this logo.
Because the less exposure young people have to alcohol promotion,
the better.
We're strong enough to say enough.
And you can be too.
Back your judgement.
Stand up for what you believe in.
Be the influence.
The Hockeyroos versus Korea. James Broadhurst in commentary with you. Looking forward to what should be an absolutely cracking game between two evenly matched sides. It's one apiece so far in the series, so one team will get ahead here today. Without further ado, let's head over to Friz Ferguson.
Thank you very much, James. Yes, I have Edwina, or Eddie Bone, with me. She made her debut for Australia on Thursday night. Now, Eddie, how did you find that debut for you?
It was very exciting. I think I'd been, it's a long time coming, I think, for me, and I've been around the group for a while, but I started on the bench, but coming out and holding that number and trying to get, you know, my player off the field, it took me a while, but as soon as I got on there, I think getting that emotion out onto the field and relaying it into some energy and some positive things and getting that first touch and things like that, it was really exciting, and I'm glad I was out there. And I mean, it was quick, but yeah, I think I adjusted really well, so it was good.
Fantastic. And Korea won on Thursday night. What do the team have to do today to get the win?
Yeah, we've spoken about that a lot over the past kind of day or so, and just fixing up our structure, making sure everyone's on the same page this week, putting in that effort and making sure that we're working really hard for each other. So not just individually, but for everyone that's playing out on that field today. So, yeah.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much, and enjoy watching today.
Great, thank you.
Back to you, James.
Yeah, great work. Thank you for that. Friz Ferguson joining me in commentary today will be Jade Taylor. And Jade, wonderful series so far, hasn't it?
An umpire.
Yeah, I think it's
Carl Berry in Darwin. Sadly, having removed a snake into the bush area outside of the hockey centre prior to a training session, he then removed the snake, put it into the bush, went for a run, and unfortunately came back and collapsed. Carl was an umpire in Northern Territory, a senior player, and also a coach of the Commerce team in Northern Territory. Hockey Australia and Hockey WA wish to pass our sincere condolences on to the family and to the Northern Territory hockey community. Thank you.
Thank you. Starting for Korea today.
The number 10 captain.
Okay, well, certainly somber news to start off the game here, Jade. Unfortunate when the hockey community loses anyone, and certainly in those circumstances, not good at all.
Yeah, no, and I'm sure that the girls will probably take this into the game and really come out firing to pay their respects today.
Well, speaking of the Hockeyroos, they went down in that second game on Thursday night. The series now level one apiece. How do you see this one panning out?
Oh, look, today's been set up to be a really great match. The Koreans really took it up to the Australians on Thursday night, and I'm sure that both teams spent yesterday and this morning going through both the games, and then figuring out the way that they can best use their strengths. I think today will be quite interesting, and it's a little bit warmer today, which is nice. So
very hot. Just spent 30 seconds down on the boundary line, nearly melting. So these girls have got 2 times 35. You're the student, you should know the answer to that.
Yep, 70.
70, beautiful. 70 minutes of hockey ahead of them. So in this heat, which certainly will be a factor. Do you think that favours the Australians, or the Koreans won't be too fussed about that?
Like I've mentioned before, the Koreans are coming off a fairly solid training block, so I'm sure that they'll be prepared. Yeah, the Aussies, with our training schedule at the moment, we are doing a lot of kind of 10 to 12 o'clock during the day sessions, and we've been blessed with beautiful weather still here in Perth. So, they'll be raring to go.
All right, so only seconds away from a start here. Game 3, Australia versus Korea. And the changes to the Australian lineup today, Kronk, Claxton and Maria Williams making her debut, come in at the expense of Paris Lynch and Bone. So another player being blooded here today, starting on the bench, is Maria Williams. But can you tell us a little bit about her, Jade?
Yeah, Maria's a fairly new coming to the squad. She's been in the junior teams for a few years now, and is a really dynamic striker. So she'll fit quite perfectly into this team today. So we wish her all the best for her first game.
Yeah, absolutely. Here's Attard with the hit from the sideline. Expecting any changes in tactics from either side today, Jade? We saw the Aussies in the first two games employ that very aggressive forward press, and obviously that worked well for them, particularly in the second half of the first game. But last game got found out a little bit maybe. Do you think they'll change it up or just work on it and try and perfect it?
No, I think they'll continue to work on the press. It is one of the driving forces of picking up the tempo of the game for our team. So I think the press will pretty much stay the same. What might change a little bit is the outletting structure. So did a little bit of work on that this morning, and just tightening up a little bit, making sure that whenever someone's got the ball, they've always got at least two, if not three or four options.
Messant draws a crowd and also draws a free hit. That came off a streaking run down the sideline from Flanagan. Chain of passes. Shot was on its way from White, but the Koreans avert crisis there. So early opportunity there for Australia. That was a well-worked 4A forward, wasn't it?
Yeah, very good. And I like Kelly White's determination in the circle to get a really quick shot away. She is known for that and can definitely hit a goal. She's been showing that in training, so she'd be really hoping to put that into play today.
Cross from Blythe, deflected by Nanscorn, but it's wide. So early on, the Aussies looking to press hard here against the Koreans. Of course, they scored in the first opening minute or so in game 2. That was Madonna Blythe, but after that point, it was all Korea, more or less, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. And look, the Koreans certainly won't be letting that one, or forgetting that one. Look, they're holding their structure quite well. In defence, they scramble really well too. So I think they'll be looking to win the ball here and try and get that quick counter-attack that they're known for.
Well, they're getting a bit of work here defensively because they're under the pump in the first 3 minutes of the game here. Aussies doing all the attacking. This is Flanagan again going on a long run. Finds a teammate. That was Claxton. Her ball, Messant couldn't quite trap it. So it goes over the baseline. But Claire Messant, she loves a goal, doesn't she? So no surprise to see her up there in a scoring position.
Yes, she certainly does.
Okay, here go the Koreas. That's a great outlet for them. This is Char. Char's ball is just in front of Chun. But once again, we see just how quickly they can transition it.
Yeah, look, I think the Aussies will certainly look at that press a little bit suspect, being able to hit between the striker and the inside forward there, which in effect really cuts out the first six of your press. So they won't be wanting to let that happen again, I don't think.
Here's Claxton running onto the ball, charges goalward. It's in a dangerous spot. Keeper has to come out, kicks it away, hasn't completely cleared it. Claxton again on the reverse. Can they control it on the baseline? The Aussies, they do. Can they get a shot away now? Oh, once again, the Koreans were all over it and smothered that shot. So they allowed the ball through. And, Parker's got she's got a Park to play with. Only the goalkeeper to beat. It is Kronk. Support comes from Attard. Kronk played that very well. The shot's still away, but Attard on the post, able to knock it away. Golden opportunity for Korea. But they did well. Gee, yeah. Tony Kronk just did not panic in that scenario at all, did she?
No, not at all. And I think the Park will be a little bit disappointed with that shot. We tend to say, when you're shooting at goal, hit the professional side, not that she hit the near side post. So in her mind, she'll be a little bit disappointed with that shot because they always want to hit across the goal, at least to hit the opposite post rather than that near one.
Well, a couple of times already, the Koreans have really managed to smash through that press, haven't they? So, certainly a lot of things for Adam Commons to think about. There's a little mistake in the back line, lets the Aussies in here. Here's Messant. Nanscorn fighting hard, had three to beat. And we've got a whistle that goes the way of Korea. Korea just have that great ability to absorb a pressure, don't they? We saw it just moments before when ball was in the D for the Aussies and the Koreans, no panic, and able to clear it and clear it well and create an opportunity of their own. This is Flanagan now. And we saw Park in the previous two games be a dangerous player. We mentioned someone that's not necessarily in the game all the time, but certainly bobs up and can be a game breaker.
Yeah, it can really have a huge amount of impact. And even from her tempo on her leading, I know I've mentioned her leading before, but it's Como showed the clip from yesterday's game where she scored the goal, and the speed at which he makes that initial lead to then off-put the defender, and it's just a little dart back, and here we go again. They're on the burst.
Here she is again, getting behind the defence. The pass to her wasn't great, kind of dribbled off the stick. She still gets an opportunity, but numbers back now. Jenna was there. She controls it, Park. She's going to get a shot away, and once again it's wayward, but she is creating heart murmurs so far in the Australian defence, just in the first 5 minutes or so here.
Wow. We've seen certainly a few shots at either end, which is setting up a nice little game here. It should be a bit exciting, I think.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a shootout so far. No goals scored, but some good opportunities created. Here come the Aussies. They work it to the midfield. They go back again. This is Attard. Saved that goal a few minutes ago. Lines up a hit. Messant has it, turns around, runs wide. She's trapped by O. Is close now on the baseline. Can they do something creative here, the Aussies? Once again, the Koreans are good back there. And a steal here from Hong. And eventually gets the whistle. So intercept, partial at least, to Hong. If they can get through here, it'll be danger signs again. It was Kim lurking behind. Fortunately, Jenna was able to get a stick in. If she hadn't, well, Kim would have been off to the races again, you'd suspect. Really dangerous the way they get behind that. Jeez, it's... Oof. They're happy to... Both sides happy to stick with their tactics, though, so it's a real interesting contrast in styles, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. And look, with the way that the Australians, the way that we do set out our outletting is that we try and get, you know, a couple of extra up high to give us the forward momentum, which does expose you at the back. So if you do lose possession quickly, you really need to scramble to get back to cover the dangerous lines.
Showing a lot of confidence in the back line. They work it into the D here, the Aussies, and they win themselves a penalty corner. So, very fast and fluid game so far. And first penalty corner of the game goes the way of the home side. And we saw they had a few difficulties with the penalty corner the previous two games. Something they really want to take full toll of, because they're perfect opportunities to score and you really need to make the most of them. It's like McMahon and Flanagan setting up in the Aussie battery. See how they go here. Ball's in play. It goes to Flanagan. They try to McMahon. McMahon shot on target. They still haven't cleared. They have now, Korea. So, shot was okay. Gave the Korean keeper some work to do, but not the result they wanted. What's here? We've got a whistle and a player off. It's Claxton and Madonna Blythe. Well, she's querying the decision, but it won't change it. Claxton's off the pitch with a green card. How'd you see that?
Yeah, look, we've been working on those kind of tackling where we call it the takeover tackle, where you essentially pick the speed of the player that's running with the ball and shave underneath. And Yeah, look, I think in that case, Jane did quite a good job. It's, I suppose, educating maybe the umpires on how. I mean, it's a tough one because you do have to use a little bit of body, but effectively you're not really blocking the ball because you're taking the speed of them. So
there is Jane. Yeah, poor contemplating Jane. That tactic.
Well, I think that's two tackle. Games, two cards now, poor Jane.
All right, well, she can't help her side for the next few minutes. And Korea with a player up, what can they do with it? Can they take advantage? Working the back line. Very hot day, some of the Koreans still electing to go with the long sleeves. This is Cha, one of those players, God knows why, but might be a habitual thing. A lot of sports people are very superstitious about having everything the same, aren't they, before every game?
Yes, I'm not one of those people.
Maybe the Koreans are because they've gone the long sleeves. About half the side, looks like, in this weather. This is Johnston. Now to McMahon. Has to go back to Johnston now. Has Blythe free on the broadcast side. She tried to get her, but the pass was just a bit too fierce there. Korea take over. This is Cha. One of those players in the Korean lineup that seems to be able to find targets from a long range. They work it well to the other side here, to the visitors. And forward. Oh, that's a great ball. This is Cho. Cho trying to elude the defenders. Kronk has to stick the boot out. But once again, Cho was in a one-out position in the D, and it's been the case with several Korean players so far in this game and indeed this series. So they're really working those situations that they want.
Yeah, I'm sure Jason sitting upstairs, our defender coach, won't be too impressed with that kind of play at the moment because we are giving them a little bit too much space behind us. We talk about being on a flat triangle as a defender so that you can still see the ball and the player at the same time. So in that instance, I think Johnston or Kirst just lost sight of the player and it gives them the ability to get one or two steps away from you.
There's an errant pass from McMahon. In Korea, the opportunity here. Lee out to Park. Park centering into the D, fight for it. Crucial battle, and well, they did well there. That was Joyce on this occasion. She won herself a whistle, so no damage done. Ball into a dangerous spot. It seems to me, correct me if I'm wrong, Jade, it seems that when Korea go forward, even on ones that aren't the quick break, such as the example here, they just seem to be able to clear the D a bit more than when the Aussies go forward. Maybe the Koreans get better at getting back and blocking up the D.
Yeah, look, and they also, we find that they tend to attack with just one or two players and end up, the Aussies will be outnumbering them, but they still manage to find the ball. And sometimes when you are outnumbering a team, it puts a little bit of indecision into who's actually taking the player.
Here's Smith. Of course, played her 50th game.
Mm-hmm.
That was Thursday night?
Yes, Thursday night.
The youthful veteran.
Yeah. I think she'll be a name that will be around for a long time to come.
Oh, and the sprinkler came on there momentarily. That's a bit of a glitch there. Fortunately, the game can continue here. Smith. And once again, Koreans do well. That was Cha with the tackle to dispossess the Australians, and now they'll hit up the line. Was looking for Jonghee Kim. She couldn't get her stick on it, so went over the sideline of Australia's ball. McMahon's slap hit forward, can't find a target. So Korea now look to build again. Will hit forward, well controlled again by Cha. She draws a couple of Australians. And we see that pressure working for the Aussies on this occasion. Nanscorn was behind, couldn't get the ball. Good hustle there from Claxton. Attard's there to help out, but still going and showing some great skills is Lee. She holds things up now and centres the ball. This is Arne. Arne gets away from three players. Her ball, well, may have been for Park or may have been intended for further down the field. Either way, it sailed harmlessly through the D.
It's a beautiful little turn there in the centre to beat the three Australian players. They're sneaky. I keep saying it, they're sneaky.
Yeah. Youngsil Lee, great skills there. And also from Arne, she drew three players. The player slips over. This gives Nanscorn a good run at the goal. And they win themselves a penalty corner. So Nanscorn, as soon as she saw that player slip over, she put the pedal to the metal, didn't she, and charged Goldwood.
Yeah, it's one of her really good qualities is George's speed, but speed with the ball. It's all good and well being able to run fast, but you've got to be able to do it with the ball. And she's certainly one of the front runners in that instance.
Over the 100 metres, she the quickest?
No. There's a few girls that really can build up a fair amount of speed. It's getting fairly even at the moment in terms of who's the quickest. But you know, we are trying, you know, to really improve our speed and our strength. So it can certainly be a determining factor in the game. So.
Looks like we've got Claxton and McMahon in for this one, and McMahon's shot took a fair piece of a Korean stick, I'd suggest. Am I correct in seeing that? And couldn't make it through. That's a great pass again. Kim with the ball. Now this is Dare Kim still going. And ball out here to the other Kim. Okay, Ju Kim just in front of her. But once again, the Koreans able to streak up the field.
Classic training drill, that one. Ended up being almost a 3-on-2 for the Koreans. And you know, we do talk about in training, if we set up a drill where it's three attackers on two defenders, guaranteed most of the time the attackers will get a shot at goal. And it's then transferring that into the game where there's, you know, a whole lot of other pressures involved.
Here's Johnston now. Runs the sideline, cuts in board. And well, she's made it through the legs of a Korean player there, but there's a whistle. And it'll be back. So Johnson's ball. Still no score. Over 18, just under, I should say, 18 minutes remaining in this first half. It's been fairly action-packed for a nil-all scoreline so far.
Yeah, and it feels like there's a lot more communication out there today. It was a big... as well done by
Smith,
Kelder, hold it in there. But communication was a talking point that came up in our talking point that came out in our meeting.
No pun intended.
Yeah, no pun intended. And look, it certainly sounds like the girls have taken note of that. Here we go. Park in behind again.
There's Park, and Kronk is there. Kronk has come out off her goal line. Jenna is back as well, and well, after the initial mistake. And you can probably see Tony Kronk giving some, no doubt, polite instruction to her defenders. But,
yeah.
Wow, that was another one. And Park, well, you'd think she'd gobble those up. She's had two golden opportunities so far, but let the Aussies off the hook.
Yeah, I mean, she holds up the ball a little bit. So it meant that two of the Australians could get back into the play there. So Tennille, who ended up smothering the shot, did a fantastic job of getting back in the play, but Kronk does well then to hold her up too.
Yes.
So it, you know, by buying time, we can get players back in to pressure the shot.
So the Aussies scramble well in defence and prevent the goal. Nelson fighting with Char. Eventually coming through is Parker. Now it's out to Claxton. Claxton sideways to Attard. She goes further out to Messent. Messent straight into the stick of a Korean. And they win the ball. And there was a one-on-one up the line. They chose to ignore that. It was Chun lurking up forward. She's got Jenna marking her very closely. And they try to switch the play. Nothing doing. No one home for Korea. Nelson. This is White. McMahon. Looks forward and sideways to Flanagan. Flanagan has Joyce in support. Now McMahon, they switch it to the other side with Jenner. And a deflection here, but the Aussies retain possession. So.
Yeah, they're doing quite well at holding it around the back here, making some good passes with a bit of ball speed, which helps. You know, you end up passing time onto the next player. So I just need to sharpen up on the final execution of the pass going forward.
Important that Jenna trapped that, and she did. Joyce. Her ball to Nelson is good. Nelson, good fight from the West Aussie to retain possession for Australia there. Here's Messant. Out to Parker. Still has it, Parker. On the reverse, nothing doing. Again a reverse. It was from Messant, but on this occasion there's another penalty corner.
What's this, number three?
Number three, yes. So can they take advantage of this one? Be interesting to see how they go with. They've given McMahon the responsibility on both occasions so far. First one was a little what do you call that play?
Swoosh. The swoosh, I think.
Is it the swoosh,
yeah.
Is it? And second one was a straight up attempt. Both times on target, both times denied.
Mm-hmm. And we saw them score off a rebound in Thursday night's game. So they need to be either a bit sharper on the rebounds or more accurate with their shooting.
Okay. Ball's in play. The trap. Well, didn't give them an opportunity. They still have the ball, though. Here's Parker. And it's over the sideline now. Claxton now. Goes this way and that. Into the D, does she? No. Whistle just outside. And that's another penalty corner attempt. Well, frittered away, yes.
Yeah.
From... I'll just watch this ball come in. It doesn't make its way to the D. As Korea able to run it out through Kim. Cut in board now. Four Australians around that ball. That means Okju Kim was free. They've still managed to force it on here. Collision in the D. But it came off the Korean's foot, so it'll be an Aussie ball. It seems like it's should be, and I know it's not, but it should be one of the more simpler things, the penalty corner scenario. But obviously there's a lot of technique and those sort of things to it that are the reason for the variance in the results, I guess.
There is, there's a whole lot of techniques, but there's only one person concentrating on the one technique. So, in theory, it should be, it's such a closed skills.
Yeah.
And here we see the Koreans 4-on-4 in this situation.
Great ball through. Can Cho get a shot away? It's just within reach. She gets it on the baseline. She still has it. Tries to flick it back to a teammate. Aussies did well not to get it on their boot on that occasion.
Good patience by McMahon and Flanagan there.
I thought Cho was away. Their ball was just out of her reach, though. And we've seen that a lot, though, from the Koreans. Little kick on from Nanscorn was good. Found Smith. Now Nanscorn running in support, gets the ball now. Can she go all the way here, Nanscorn? She can't. She's held up. But there's a free hit, so Smith now with an opportunity. What does she do? Flicks it back. Is Attard close on the baseline? Can they get a shot away? They do. It was Nelson. It was a fair attempt from where she was at, facing away from the goal, but couldn't go in. So it was a fairly well worked play under duress there, the Aussies getting a shot away.
Yeah, and look, we do try and really, once we get the ball going forward, go at speed. And with that comes sometimes a little bit of mishandling, I suppose, of the ball, and it's being able to really consolidate. And here we see the Koreans breaking again.
Johnston it was, but we've seen on the ground Young Sil Kim with the one hand on the stick work a couple of times now, like showing off her ball control. And it's really creating havoc through the midfield as far as the Australians are concerned. Now here's an opportunity for Close. She has a paddock to work in. Attard's up forward. Nelson runs hard as well. It goes to Blythe. She uses Smith. Great tackle here from Char.
What I was enjoying there is half the Koreans just stopped and walked and let the Australians run away from them. So, look, if the Aussies can keep up this kind of intensity, here we go again. It's such a run-and-gun game at the moment.
It certainly is. Here's Kim with a great opportunity. She gets around Kronk, but could not get anything on the shot. So Kronk, well, did enough there. She would have thought for a moment when she saw the player go past her that she was going to concede a goal, but did enough on the charge out to cause the Korean to lose control of the ball there.
Yeah, and I'm seeing there was a few girls with their hands on their knees just then, just sucking in the big ones. It must be pretty hot work out there today. And with the backwards and forwards type game, this is where you can really fatigue quite quickly because you're having to do the sprints backwards and forwards. So I think the Aussies would be looking to try and just calm the tempo a bit here. Get a little bit of, say, rest time in their legs.
Wouldn't back themselves to run the Koreans in the ground, though?
Oh, I think so. But look, when you're fatigued, the skill level then drops. So they want to be making sure that they can perform all their skills, effectively and well, so that they can get a score on the board.
Here's Flanagan. White now runs onto it. Cross in. Squirts free. And just for a moment, I thought it may have squirted out the back, not to be. There's a deflection here. Park can't run onto it. Fortunately for Australia, because she may have been away there if she had. Great tackle by Flanagan. Now she goes inboard to Blythe. Attard. What's she got forward? She had Nelson. Nelson can't quite get there. This is Dare Kim. Looks to cross to the middle. The idea was right. Execution not quite there. Degree of difficulty, though, fair to say, was pretty high on that pass.
Yeah, very ambitious with that that attempt. Oh, look, if it had pulled off, it would have been a two on one going into the circle. So I suppose at nil all, you're prepared to take risks like that.
Absolutely. Okay, they get it to Flanagan now. She goes back. Looking for something forward is Johnston. And that pass is probably not what she wanted. And she's given it to the Koreans mid-pitch. Little ball now to Kim. Kim gets it back somehow to Ahn. Not totally sure how she did that. It was very clever. Still going. The Koreans, this is Park, draws it back. Dare Kim, well, not sure what happened there. That was not a good attempt at all.
No, Park put on a plate for her too.
Absolutely. So she'd be very disappointed in that, Kim, because we just needed to get it on target. It was nowhere near. Didn't even cross the sideline in the end. That's more like a James Broadhurst shot than an international player shot.
Well, it gave the Aussies a little bit of breathing space, but here the Koreans are on the attack again.
Here is Kim. Can she make amends? That ball is very good to Chun. And, well, air swing from her as well. So all of a sudden, with the goals in sight, the Koreans have lost their ability of us. What's going on there? That just should have been Goldwood.
Yeah, I have no idea. I can't answer that one for you at all. But look, I'm looking more to the right now, so it's kind of saying that the Koreans are really putting the pressure on the Australians at the moment.
Yeah, it is. It's letting the Aussies off the hook, though. That's two great opportunities in the space of a minute that they haven't even made the keeper do any work. So they'll be happy in one sense, the Koreans, they're creating those opportunities, but the finish on them, not great at the moment.
No.
So, well, intriguing game, this one.
I must say that half's gone fairly quickly. I looked up, there's only 5 minutes to go. And I think the Aussies will really be looking to get some momentum here to go into the halftime break, which I'm sure they're all looking forward to.
No doubt. Very warm. Okay. Australia have possession. 5 minutes to go in this half. Still looking to break the deadlock here. Attard's ball. Was that it? No. Get another chance here. Claxton. McMahon. Just works it to Attard. Centres it. Claxton has a little bit of room to move here. And, well, tried to break through. Couldn't get past. And Arne showed some nice skills. Just a little dink over the Aussie stick there and gain some extra territory.
Yeah, and that's where that little burst of speed can really come in handy. Just being able to throw that ball in front and burst away from the opposition.
This is Kim. Is it back now, Kim? And, well, she did well in the end to recover there, Sunsun Oh, because she looked under real pressure. Getting run down from behind, though, was okay, Ju Kim. And now it's an opportunity for the Aussies. Here's Blythe. If she can get through, she might be able to get a shot away. She gets it to close instead. The little flick on. The keeper was there and smothered it. So they're clear down to the other end now, the Koreans. Once again, we see them travel the length of the pitch in a short space of time. Dare Kim, great ball. Wow. Should be able to get a shot off here. Park Attard, well, the saving tackle, but it looks like she may have hurt herself here. A jarred hand, possibly.
Yeah, it's not fun. I mean, and that takes a lot of courage going in on a reverse stick shot like that. So Tennille's done very well. I think she's thwarted most of their opportunities.
Yeah, she has. Great work
well
there.
Well done by Tennille.
Yeah. Just arrived in the nick of time there. Park wound up. That had full force in it, that stroke. And, Attard wore pretty much all of that force, I think. Not surprisingly, going to come off for a breather now. He's already got a fair old mitt on the Duke there, so.
Yeah, I'd guess that probably hit her further up the wrist, which is certainly not a pleasant place to get hit.
No, certainly not. Okay. We're in the final 2.5 minutes of the half here. And, there's a mistake. Parker lines it up, and Parker sends it wide. And can't blame her for taking the shot there. She did have players in support, but probably the clearest the Korean goal has been. Here's Park again. Going one-handed. Shadowing her. This Australian player, Kim, gets a little weak flick back. And now the Australians are on the march. A lot of open space in front of Claire Messon. She decides to cover that herself. Does pass it now to Nanscorn wide. What can she do? Little stick in there from Char was only half effective. The cross came in and the Korean goalkeeper Lee forced to kick it away. I think that play right there with all the players struggling to run back just showed how much the heat has sapped these players' energy.
Yeah, look, and like I said, they'll be looking forward to the halftime break, but they'll really be wanting to say, do a little bit smarter running, I suppose, in the second half to try and make sure that they can get the full 35 of the second half.
Well, Messant was there at the top of the D. Unfortunately, she couldn't reel it in. She sent it over the sideline. Here's Kim. She can't find her way through. Joyce has it. With Claxton now out to Flanagan. This is Arne. Whistle. Goes the way of Australia. They've got 40 seconds here to do something here. If they're going to get the lead heading into halftime. Flanagan goes aerial.
Oh, and here we go, Pucks.
Free again.
On the lead again.
If they can get it to her, no. They can't. The hit was, well, a shocker, really.
Yeah, Park was in a paddock over there.
And that's exactly the scenario that they want to set up. The Koreans, they just couldn't get the right execution. Here's an opportunity for Australia. And it does go in. And, oh, boy, does that bring a lot of relief to the Hockeyroos as Emily Smith scores on the stroke of halftime. Wow.
Oh, could not have been a more perfect timing. And I think the Aussies will be, you know, reflecting on maybe the first 34 minutes, praising the pass from McMahon through to, was it Messant in the circle,
yes,
to find Smith. Look, they'll be wanting to just kind of take that into the second half, really, that momentum and the excitement that they've just got from that score.
Yeah, massive boost for them, and, well, big dagger as far as the Koreans are concerned after doing so well, probably having the better of the half, fair to say, and then they find themselves a goal down at halftime.
Well, certainly the more clear opportunities, and, you know, Park has been on the end of those, and she'll be, you know, thinking about how she might be able to get a quicker shot away or, you know, make the most of getting the ball in so much space in the circle.
Just thought that the latter stages there, the Korean skills just deserted them a touch, which is not what they wanted, certainly, given that they were creating the better of the opportunities. While we ponder that at halftime, we might head down to Friz Ferguson. She's got Tony Cronk with her.
I do. Thank you, James. I've got Tony here with me, Australia's goalkeeper. Korea are playing quite aggressive today. Does that make your job quite hard?
They always play aggressive, so I was ready for it.
Excellent. And a goal to finish off the half there. What does that mean for the team?
So we've been patient all that half, and if we can continue that patience during into the next half, then, yeah, we might be able to get a few more of those away.
And it is quite warm conditions out there. Does that make it tough on the team?
We train in a lot hotter than this, so it does make it tough, but we know that we can handle it because we can handle a lot hotter too.
Excellent. Well, good luck for the second half.
Cheers. Thank you.
All right.
And back to you guys.
Yeah, thanks for that, Frizz. Tony Cronk, tough as nails. And, of course, a couple of key moments from her thwarting the Koreans forward. Look, a couple of opportunities that you would have thought nine times out of ten the Koreans would have scored, and Tony Cronk did enough to prevent that.
Yeah, Cronky really loves those situations. She's really quick on her feet, a really mobile goalkeeper, so look, she'd be happy to take that one on any time of the day.
All right, great work by Tony Cronk and the Australians. Well, Jade might take a short break.
Once, twice, three times.
And as we might turn the microphones down the sideline, thank you, Director, we might take a short break here. We'll join you momentarily with the second half.